Here's my next project for the week. We are going to try to widen this ditch out a little bit because this is a property that we landscaped, did the dirt work, put the driveway in years ago, and then my dad's company actually did that whole entrance way and that fence and everything, but it gets a tremendous amount of water. It actually flooded and undermined the asphalt and the road and washed out half the landscaping. And this used to only be these two pipes were underneath the ground. And then the county came in and put these two 30 inches in here. So now he's got these four, and then there's two more on the other side of the road. But try to come over, I don't know, somewhere along here, yank those trees out, and then just take that grade of the ditch and pull it over, and then almost kind of have like a berm and just widen this thing up a little bit, and then get a bunch of this shot rock and stuff down here at the end. But we got quite a few trees we're gonna just take out. I'm gonna kind of dig a hole up there where we tied this ditch in and probably burn everything there. Yeah, right here, this, it washed every bit of the dirt and the landscaping and like that out, and you can see where it got up underneath the asphalt. I wanna say it was a year, it's been like this, I believe, for over a year. I think in 19 or 20, I can't remember, around Christmas time, we got a tremendous amount of rain. But yeah, all that right there, it comes down that ditch and then it can't carry all the water, so then it shoots out on this side of those trees. And he said it was just like a river that was running down. You can see, I mean, it's just rippled the asphalt and everything up. And then it I think they've come down here and dug a ditch since then. Yeah, then it ran off the edge of there, so it ripped all those shrubs up. Yeah, somebody, may have been Dad. He came down here and kind of cut a ditch straight to those, but we're going to try to get this ditch fixed, and then he's going to come in here and rip out and re-landscape this whole entranceway. We're just going to try to double the width of this thing and then build a little berm and stuff over there, but I gotta figure out how we're gonna get the excavator in here, and then we'll get started. actually his kind of his job that he does. Like I said, he still mows and maintains this guy's property, so. Something we just kind of get to work together on. Plus, I guess this is where our pile won't be super long. It'll just pile it way up. I'm hoping to be able to light this up tomorrow, but it's supposed to rain, but it's this windy. They may not like that.
We get fresh pile for compact.
Yeah. Thank you. second time to my last tree, so 2150 made it hard work getting these trees out of here. Probably ought to make sure there's no cars. I'm thinking the top of that one's gonna hit out the road. Well, this is where I got for today. So yeah, in the 3 or 4 hours that I was able to work on it this afternoon, I feel like I got a lot done. Here's my little burn pile. This is just kind of grass and roots and dirt and junk that I think there's a spot in the back lot that just loaded up in the truck and haul it off. And so I just kind of slicked it up because there's a good chance of rain tonight. But I'm gonna actually kind of slope that bank a little bit more. I'm part of this side. I'm gonna kind of get it back down to the original depth. I got more to take out on that right hand side up there, but like I said, it's just getting at the end of the day and it's getting ready to rain and run out of daylight. But I'm seriously impressed with how much work you can get done with that 2150 or just an excavator of that size in such a short amount of time. But this could have easily taken me most of the day with my 260 and the loader down here. So yeah, 3 or 4 hours with the bigger machine makes a huge difference. And like I said, used to, it was just the two smaller concrete pipes, and the county just came and put these in last year, I believe. So getting these trees out of here, making this ditch twice as wide, and now with four pipes instead of two, ought to make a huge difference. Yeah, there's still a bunch right here to take out tomorrow. Like I said, I just want to kind of get this. That's about the grade that I'm going to be in front of those two. So a lot of this right here is going to come out. This right here is probably pretty close. And then I'll get the loader down here and kind of slick it up a little bit more. I didn't get carried away with here because, I don't know, we think that's the neighbor's phone line. And right at the end of these pipes is a fiber optic line. So I didn't want to take a chance of digging this down any deeper and hooking it, so, which is fine. We'll see if we get any rain tonight and be back in the morning.